Somebody recently said our record was really good, but it wasn't as good as Blood on the Tracks by Dylan. I beg to differ. I think our record's better than Dylan's. I'll stop at Highway 61 and I'm done. That record changed the world. Those other ones didn't. Who's to say that Bob Dylan and his emotions for his breakup with his wife are more intense or more profound or better than my feelings? They're not. My breakup in my mind was as heavy as his breakup. And I think I was even more fucking brutal. You know, I was fucking honest, man. I almost fucking bled on the goddamn tape. I don't think he did. Fuck Bob Dylan. Certain artists, whether they be Radiohead, the Beatles, or Dylan, you have to compare them to their musical past. You know what I mean? You can't compare them to other artists and say, well, it's still better than, you know, you can't, well, Dylan's still better than Cat Stevens. No. You compare him to his fucking shit that changed the world and turned it upside down. That's what you compare him to. And I am going to compare John Lennon to the fucking Beatles because he was part of that glorious thing and now he's making, you know, shaved fish and shit. Yeah, you're right. That was a bad example. But Walls and Bridges then. Even if we are the shittiest band in America, if nothing else, we've been the most progressive and I think we've kind of pushed ourselves more than most bands do, wouldn't you say? The whole record's about breakups and what are we doing and the fact that everything, our careers still haven't taken off exactly the way we wanted them and divorces and just everything about growing older and questioning yourself, you know? We're at a very weird age, aren't we? We still feel incredibly young. We still hang around with young people. We still do young things. Yet all those young things and people make us feel quite old. Can't talk about if we're breaking up or not. We've taken an oath of silence and we can't. An oath of silence? Can you take an oath of silence? Yeah, sure, what the fuck. We can do whatever we want. We're Beulah. Is this Scott? Hey man, what's happening? This is Miles from Beulah. I'm doing alright. I just wanted to advance the show with you. Really? That's so weird, man. These smaller markets, that's so crazy. Fuck, I gotta get those hotel stuff. Jesus Christ. Yeah, I got something here for doubles that was about $85 a night, and they all have to be doubles. Well, you know, that one's queens or whatever the hell it was. Yeah, three rooms. Alright, cool. We'll see you soon then, man. Alright, talk to you then. Bye. Hey, man. Hey, are you gonna be by the airport today? Do you think you can pick up Brandon for me?
Turn whatever it is down real quick. Check.
Or just do your thing.
Check.
That'll be right for now. I just gotta be as loud as him. Or louder. I always have to be louder.
Yeah, you can probably take me down here, actually.
Story of his fucking life, man.
Come on.
try to help, have you?
I don't, hold on one sec. I don't know if we need any of this stuff. I think 300 would be enough for heartstrings. We've got 300 of those, 480 of the demos. We have 210 of the Yokos. I'm sorry, one sec.
Fucker.
Every minute, you know, there's something to do besides doing, you know, all this. I got a road manage. And most real bands pay some, excuse me, people to do that. I'd rather save the money at you know, at the end of the tour, have money for all the guys.
You're either ready or we're not.
Either way, we gotta fucking leave, huh? You guys sound better than us off the tour. I swear to fucking God, you better make a mistake on every song. Twice, both of you. Him, I know he's gonna fuck up left and right.
You sound good. You guys sound really good.
We sound better than him?
You guys sound bigger.
Do we?
Six people, man.
Look at me. What do we sound?
Big.
All right. I know what your game is, Beulah.
I know what your game is.
I know what you're trying to call. Miles. I'm JV's roadie.
What is this here?
It's a good job if you can get it.
This is the highlight of being in a band. Right here. Almost as good as tearing down. Almost.
Can I see the Beulah loves me in a youth large?
Sure.
How much would that be? 13?
13.
Yeah, I'm nervous, of course. First show. You don't want to be nervous though. So you pretend like you're not, you bottle it all up.
It's been like, man, a year and a half. That's a long time. Usually we have shows in between, like a little one here or there just to remember how to do it, but now it's weird. We go up there and like, fucking A, it's like, what? I don't even know what to do, you know? It feels weird. My legs feel like rubber, like, you know, every movement you make is like forced. Hopefully it'll all just lose it, you know? It sucks that your first show's gotta, you know, be in LA. LA. You know, we might get signed to a big major label tonight. You never know. We put on a good show. Big fucking major label, man. You will finally make it. Big hit on the radio.
I will say this though, bear with us. First show in a year and a half.
Way to go, everybody. First one down, 30 more to go.
Yeah. It was fine, dude. Yeah. It was the first show. I fucked up like a million times, but
right, man. It was a good show.
Huh? I just never know. I was rocking.
Don't worry.
It wasn't as good as it could have been.
Be happy. No, it's fine. It's not good.
That's why I do it.
Get on this game. 2.5 hours to San Diego. Is that how long it takes?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just depends on what time you leave.
So let's just check out at noon and leave. All right, y'all. Cheers. One down. It's only going
to
get worse.
Do on tour, drive a van, help load equipment, unload equipment, eat fast food, try not to spend any money, smoke too many cigarettes, occasionally drink too much beer, hurry up and wait, sell t-shirts, CDs. Keep the groupies away from the band and sleep occasionally.
I think it's over. Hey Brandon, just tell him to turn on the house lights.
Okay.
I don't like when there's no backstage, you know? Snot all over the place. Pretty girls leaving. They weren't cheering loud enough. Yeah, they have to earn it, you know what I mean? If they want it, cheer. If I wanted to be left alone, I wouldn't wear this shirt, would I?
Look at all them rocks.
They sure got a nice set of rocks out here.
Inspection station.
Inspection from California or something.
Wait, is this one of those fruit things and we have fruit in here sort of things?
It's California that's worried about it because of the fruit flies, right?
If we tell them we don't have bananas and then they see the bananas, they'll search every bag we have.
Looking for more bananas?
That's the thing. So just give up the bananas.
It's not like we're talking about fucking methamphetamines here. We're talking about bananas.
We have fucking bananas and a pear and they came from California. What the fuck? We're gonna have to hide these bananas. Bend over, Pat. You two, bend over. Here,
what's
come on.
Peel or no peel?
We have to hide these things.
Daddy, you're so soft.
What do you think?
You're soft.
But you're making me hard.
Now you've gone done it.
Come on, are you serious?
You shake my
fucking dude, we're not
butt.
Even moving. There's no air gonna hold that shit, yo.
Abby.
Dude, you fuck with me, you're gonna get skunked.
I heard it.
Some open windows, man.
You're gonna get skunked,
man. You're gonna get skunked.
Alright, it was just a false alarm, but you better watch it.
So when they ask me for fruit, say yes. And just
yeah, say so we have some that we've, yeah, yeah.
Score!
Oh, shit.
We got bananas in Arizona! Yeah! Bust out the nuclear bomb!
Jesus, hot out here.
It's hot out here.
That's why they call it the desert, dick.
No, dessert's supposed to be cold.
Awesome. We're going to be there because we're only about 40 miles away, and we'll start loading in the minute we get there. And then if we wanted to get going around 6, that would be wonderful. Last night in San Diego, we waited around 2 hours or maybe even longer for a sound guy, and that was awesome.
Turn on the lights, Tim. I want to see everybody. These things are going to be a fuck up. We might as well know each other. Let's all go down together, shall we? We're never supposed to apologize for shows, so I won't do that on their behalf because they don't like that. Tucson is one of those nights where things just go wrong.
Sorry to apologize, but we're going to have a talk. That was horrendous.
False. Whoever plugged in the inputs fucked up.
With the monitors and everything?
Whoever plugged in the inputs fucked them up.
It was just bullshit. It was just fucking bullshit. Things that shouldn't go wrong. Things that we pay people, you know, or whatever. Or the house person or whatever, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Anyway,
well, you know.
I'm going to have a chat with somebody and then I'm going to talk to whoever.
Let's just try to figure out who did what.
Oh, fucking A. That was a rough one tonight. I almost lost it a couple times. I was so fucking angry. But it bums me out that after you have kids pay so much money, you know what I mean? You come to a place once in 6 years and you don't really play as up to par, you know, and everything goes wrong. It's just like, it's so weird. That's just a bummer. You gotta rely on other people, you know, and you practice just to be good on your own, but you can't really control your own destiny so much, you know? You can play perfect and you still get off stage and someone will say, man, that sound sucked, you know what I mean? You just go, wow, really? I thought I just played the best show of my fucking life, and the sound sucked, you know?
Well, you know what we'll do from henceforth? We'll have Jay set up the mics and check, check, check. It should be coming right out of that bad boy.
The blessing of the whole thing is that you guys sounded good through the whole thing.
Right.
And
did it sound all right, really?
I would tell you, I would feel even worse if it sounded bad.
You're not being
honest, dude. I take this pretty seriously.
Yeah, no.
I
appreciate that. I appreciate that you do. That means a lot to me. So,
all right, man.
We'll be all right. We'll rock it. We'll rock it the next couple of days, and we'll just, you know, like I said, we'll just fix whatever needs to be fixed.
Definitely.
That's good. We'll be all right. You know, I guess it's better to get it out in Tucson than it is in New York. You know what I mean?
You want me to drive some?
No, I'm cool.
You're not cool.
I'm cool for driving. Okay.
Get the fuck out of here.
Semantic Sam.
There's some serious Photoshop going on that pussy.
Yeah, totally.
It's like fuchsia.
It looks like it's lavender. Probably some sort of weird, you know, lotion or something.
Lavender.
Yeah, it's all smeared, all perfect. Like,
well, it comes not supposed to be lavender?
Carbo, North Carolina. We should put it on the list.
Fill her up.
Pump the gas. That's my job. And Danny's job is to watch and make sure I don't screw it up.
Did you prepay yet?
There's just one of those moments where you're driving along after leaving a gas station, you go, God, is the gauge broke or something? What the fuck is up with this? Still it empty. Did you pump it up there, Swanee? I know, yeah, he says he pumped it up. He didn't pay for gas. We paid for some air.
I was assuming someone had already pumped the gas. And then when I came back, it was, it had a number on it.
What do we say about assumptions?
Never assume.
So it's just like flickering, fucking.
Yeah, it's interesting. Like this somebody spilled beer on it, basically. Is that what happened?
Yeah.
But they had to go through and like say what was good and what was bad, and I had to circle the ones that the faders are good, but the bum buns are bad, and it's all B. You'll notice. So to like find the.
I had to write down the ones that are bad. Look at that.
This is the how not to class. Just labeling. I know everything is at. Otherwise, I'd be lost. This knob. When the Beulah starts to play, this goes up to 10.
Oh, man.
It's just to equal out the playing field a little bit.
Oh.
Marty.
Hey, so Texas is working out for you though, right, John?
We will.
Texas is working out for y'all, young boys.
Yeah, those all those hairless chihuahuas you like.
Get with it.
Five. Did you get the John Vander Slice cock rings yet?
Dude, all you're obsessed about is like, fuck you. And that's not cool, you know? We're on tour here. We're
it's
trying to make
very
music.
Twee, basically.
Yeah, dude.
You lack tweeness.
Yeah. Well, I don't know about tweeness. He lacks penis.
Hey!
You really gotta be nice to your band. I mean, because they're starting to hate you, you know? You're like some sort of weird dictatorial, like Howard Hughes motherfucker. It's not cool. Okay? We're gonna have to take you in our band for a little bit. Teach you some humility.
I don't know. Yeah, we'll figure it out. Maybe ran over something. Who knows? But we'll call you if there's any other problems. But we'll probably just be fine. We'll just get past or whatever.
Maybe Tate gave us some luck.
See that?
Whoa!
So it's actually from the side or something, isn't it?
Oh, you have to. It's in the back. It's up there. Okay. It says open the rear doors and remove some screws from entry seat.
Remove what?
All right. That's good, John.
Oh yeah, you can see it right there. So.
Thing, right?
The emergency brake on nipple-ish.
So I didn't need to.
You turn it clockwise.
Oh, feeling cold.
Take a few less battings of the cheek there. But, should we, before we bring it up, we should take the nuts off, huh?
Yeah. The Long Island wheel stealer.
They're in my pocket.
Here it goes, buddy.
Here. Reserve.
I don't want.
This is gonna make me slip off.
Well, it wasn't working without the WD-40. So
what we need is a longer.
This might work.
It's my gig bag.
You see, it just hopped right off.
On triple A.
I don't know a lot about cars, but I would say, yeah, I'm gonna diagnose it as a flat tire.
Texas is just too big. Those drives are just never ending, you know?
Live at noon, huh?
Yeah.
Shit.
See, we should do like a man like me. So that's a pretty easy one, don't you think?
Yeah.
I've been waiting all night long. Well, I've been waiting to sing your song tonight. If you help me, just help me find your key. I run my hands down your neck, across your back to another thread. I know, girl, you're fragile, you're bound to self-destruct.
Bill?
Oh, try lifting all your weight for a man. A man gone wrong. And try wasting all your days on a man like me.
See, that one sounds good.
Arnold, could you possibly show us how many brain cells you currently have?
I have one.
Did they tell you they rented some guitars? Oh, they are? Oh, that's quick. So we're supposed to go on 12 sharp?
About 10 after 12, okay. But I mean, it's kind of free form.
Are you guys gonna do those ahs?
Nah. Well, you want to? We haven't practiced in a long time.
How do they go?
You wanna try that real quick?
Yeah.
You wanna soak up and sing that first verse? One, two, three.
Baby says I'm tearing it down, shoulder to shoulder, I hold it too lightly. Baby says your kiss don't do anything.
Okay, the band is Beulah. Why are you called Beulah?
You know, I don't know anymore. I think I wish we could change the name now. Call it Miles and Company. Let's just do this. I'll just start with
notice the silence.
One, two, three, four.
intentions, the palsy dominions where the highway's not far. When all you know, your shadow's a ghost, don't let it scare you away.
I was looking on the website and it said Nashville and it said TBA. So I emailed them asking them when they were gonna come, and so they told me, and it was at 12th and Porter, and I was like, those shows are always either 18 over 21 and older, and I'm only 17. And they were like, well, hey, show up at 5 o'clock and you can hang out for the sound check.
A lot of people think that we have a choice in the matter, and a lot of times we don't, because there's a booking agent and there's the club, and usually they're talking about money. We had to pay $100 out of our pocket before we even showed up for extra security just to have an all ages show. Here they don't offer that.
Jesus.
And said you should get down here for the sound check. 20 minutes later, I'm sitting in front of Beulah watching them play.
Surreal kind of stuff like this is supposed to happen.
I just came just to see them because I'm not 18 yet. Although I look 32.
Seriously, you guys should skip Cookeville tonight. Come to Hendersonville. We'll show you Johnny Cash's house.
You can stay at my house.
His stepmom has an Emmy. Come on. Johnny Cash and an Emmy. There's nothing in Cookeville. We have Johnny Cash's dead body.
They kicked us out, but it was against the artists.
Yeah, John Vanderslice was protesting. He's a good man.
Tell John that if his singing career doesn't work out, he should be a teacher.
All right.
Or a librarian.
A librarian.
The other day he actually said goodbye, but he didn't just now. He said in one phone call, he said hi, daddy, and bye bye. That was the first time he's ever said that. That was really cool.
So it starts here and goes that way.
That way.
Exactly. So yeah, one block over. Let's rock it.
Let's go this way.
Executive Park, is that cool with you guys?
But hell, I mean, our tax dollars pay for this shit, so we should come here at 3 in the morning and look at the shit. You know what I mean?
It's going to be a nice picture of Swan with the black background.
Yeah, exactly.
City Hall is bigger than that.
I disagree. Because
there's that bottom circle and then the middle one up there, but maybe the top, like the very top, the round thing that starts to come up, maybe that's smaller. But not
the cock,
when you consider
cock,
like, yeah, the head of the cock, yeah,
but the shaft.
There, but the other part down, no, that's not smaller. Definitely not smaller.
This is like the problem in modern times. You come out to this place, it's supposed to be all
sacred
and cool, and then there's fucking porta potties, you know, and tractors. And tractors are kind of cool, but they just don't give a shit.
Mikroski invites four bespectacled guys on stage. You wonder, is he really being kind or is he really being cruel or something to that effect? Because they can never find the beat, and you know, in some way it's like, I don't know, but it sounds awful. Like, is he being sinister by bringing up these four nerds basically and letting them
fucking
rock up?
Cocksucker, man.
He's trying to neatly fit it into his rhetorical puzzle, though.
Well, that and, you know, he's just making a lot of assumptions there. That,
exactly.
That, like,
We're making fun of our own audience.
Right. Just because he thinks they're dorks.
Just because he's having cruel thoughts about them.
At least we're in the Times. A lot of people read it. Thing is, no one knows anything about the building, and that, oh, and they hired an independent sound people to make sure this happens. Well, the sound people just called me and said they think there's going to be problems because they don't think they have enough power, and they don't know where any of the outlets are, they don't know how to run this building, and there's no one to tell them about the building, and they can't get into the building until 6 p.m. tonight to configure a sound system that's never been in there before. I mean, they have to set up sound at 6. The doors are at 8, Jordan. I don't know what the fuck's going on. Yeah, where are you, Jordan? Exactly. Yes. Where were you earlier today? Where are you later today? And where are you this evening? Where are you tomorrow?
It was supposed to be done by 6. The reason it's gone longer is we've had a bunch of questions from the class.
This is kind of getting weird.
Yeah.
And I'm getting a little freaked out. Because the doors are supposed to be at 8. We have sound people, we have light people, we got to put together a show. And it's like past 6 o'clock now.
There's just people, there's a bunch of hippies in there learning how to cook hippie fucking food in there. And I mean, it's 6, and they're supposed to be out at 6, and they say they're gonna be finishing up soon. I mean, doors are at 8. I'd rather go home. Yeah, she's there. She's like 20 years old. She doesn't know what she's doing. She's just like biting her nails. I didn't know it was a living room though, Jim. I thought it was actual, like, you know, when I hear the word rotunda and you read about it and it says rotunda, I thought it was a fucking thing. I'm not playing a fucking show without a goddamn sound check. I won't do it. I don't give 2 fucks. Can I cancel it? And what would that mean if I cancel? Huh? A little late, you mean?
Hey, we're on our way around Walnut. Okay, don't start unloading anything yet, because Miles says there's something. Alright, we're gonna be there in about 20 minutes or so probably. Well, we're just in massive traffic, Philly traffic, so I'm giving us some time. Alright, bye.
Praise be Allah! We're gonna go to this campus.
Allah!
We're gonna show them what Allah means.
Allah!
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 Allah! Allah!
Allah! Allah! Pray to Allah, for he is good. He brings the fruit.
Barbecue.
It feels great to be alive. It ain't no big thing, and I know what it's like.
I live my city with a corner of cracks. What's going on? What's going on? Come on!
We should go to Lancaster and play for the Amish folk. They ain't seen shit like this ever.
Keep driving, eventually you'll hit the freeway.
Check out the girl in the pink shoes!
Whoa, yeah!
Pink shoes!
It's the rotunda.
It's round.
Come on, fucking run that fucking guy over.
So you can't, Nick.
Fucking rerun out there.
La la la!
Not here.
Well, no, because the thing is, who thinks it's in there?
Yeah, I'm like, it's gotta be in here, right, Eli?
It's gotta be.
There's even sound stuff in there. It's gotta be in here. This is an actual theater.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's like a church.
What a bitch, actually. It's a rotunda, too.
You know, I have a feeling it's back there because my friend who I told him we're playing here, he's like, I don't think that place is big enough for you guys.
Okay, you're going to see how this is, and it's kind of a makeshift. It's just going to be, and it's all the way around the corner here where this.
What happened to Volvo Man?
Who is Volvo Man?
Is everyone in the same kind of state of disbelief? It's like, what? You don't have anything here? That's funny.
I feel good. It's a nice looking place. It's round. It looks like a church. It's got pews and stuff. It's gonna be nice. I think we're playing in that little room.
Is everything else okay?
Mm-hmm, great. Cool. Wonderful. Everybody seems to be quite happy. It looked like lemons and we turned it into lemonade. But you turned it into lemonade. It looked horrible at first. We were scared. But I'll tell you this. This place is better than the Casbah in San Diego.
All right.
If anyone has stage fright in that situation, like people looking right at you, it's just like, ugh. Normally like that, I'll just kind of, my eyes will just sort of haze out. You know how you can kind of let your eyes sort of drift? I'll just like kind of drift at the microphone.
The New Jersey Turnpike sucks. You know, you can't really describe it until it's happened. I don't know if it's better or worse than the Connecticut Turnpike, though. That's the real debate. Because the Connecticut Turnpike sucks, too. Actually, the whole Turnpike concept's bullshit.
Count Succula.
You're on this freeway, and you can't really get off unless you pay money. And then, like, the only places you can stop are, like, McDonald's and, like, overpriced gas places.
Turnpike is a proctologist's dream. If my driving makes anyone nervous, I'm more than happy to switch.
I think it's Miles.
Hey.
Come back.
Would you like Patrick to nav for you guys? Or actually, you know what? Yeah, you want him to navigate if you switch?
No, I don't know where to go.
Okay.
Man, it's gonna be fun on that tour bus next tour.
When we have that driver and everything?
Fuck yeah.
I don't know, where are the streets here? Oh.
The only problem is we're kinda...
Here's what we're gonna do, we're just gonna try to
ride. Tight squeeze here.
Yeah.
I don't think I can make this.
Yeah, wait for the gimps.
See where the van is up there.
Yeah, I should have turned right on that. I should have turned right on that last street right there.
It wouldn't make a difference.
I am relaxing.
Fucking do that.
Don't tell me how to drive.
Stop
the fucking
van. End of story.
Don't backseat fucking drive.
That's it. If I say stop the fucking van,
shut up. Let me drive.
Hey guys.
Fucking faggot.
That's not curing shit. I apologize for you, that was out of line, I apologize. Could I say stop, just stop the fucking van.
What I've done in the past is like I do like a couple plates of chicken, falafel, rice, salad, hummus tabbouleh.
Okay, there's that. I guess I'll do a guest list with you too.
Yep.
And then do we need bracelets or stamps? We're just gonna
actually
go in
Niani, who's at the end of the bar.
Yeah.
She has the
bracelets. Last time we were here, we had some problems. It was a bit suspect how many people were here. Because it was pretty packed.
Really?
No, the number we were given at the end of the night.
Uh-huh.
And it's not often that I say the number, and they go, oh, how many people are there, Miles? And then everyone goes, what? Again, it was some of those door people, it was a little odd. You see, I have an assistant kid that just counts heads.
Yeah.
So I'll introduce him to the door person, so if they ever see him and they want to go, what's
fine.
This?
I'll give him just a clicker if he wants.
Yeah, no, we brought our own.
Okay.
It seems different, and Jim had told him there's a lot of different people working, and it feels different, and more together.
Yeah, I hope so.
Yeah, so awesome.
Why has this been around? What is this?
That's Megan's.
We'll be right back.
old drummer I used to play with, Christopher, would talk about this like angsty boredom, this fidgety boredom that would drive him insane after shows, because you have all this pent up stuff, and it is tapped. It's tapped. The keg is tapped.
All right, you ready for number two? You ready? All right. Oh, that was all right. Woo!
I think I'm fine.
Reminds me of my days back in Tijuana. So they weren't CDs, they were people.
Basically every American band that I've ever known of going to Canada goes through all this to try to hide most of their merch.
Yeah. I think the hiding the merch thing is a little silly.
Even though they charge a lot, you'd want to pay all the tariffs.
Yeah, probably.
It might make playing in Canada like totally completely unprofitable.
Right. Well, no, I just wouldn't play in Canada, personally.
Hey, Brandon. We're taking our own merch.
Right.
I'm going to be in charge of telling how much we have. However, if they ask any of you, we sell our t-shirts and our CDs for
$8.
Okay? And we sell, the posters are for free, if they ask. Just if they ask any of that. $8 and $8 and free, the rest of it. You know, it's promotional.
I'm Lando Calrissian, man. It's my gang, all right? I'm the fucking Black Beauty.
You're going to have to give that you're going to have to give up your Carhartt to a Jawa.
I'm fucking Billy T. Williams.
Hey, what should I say about the thing when they ask about Pat? Should I say, he just hooked up with a girl and he's not coming?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna make it seem like it's real mellow. We're not
see
a big band.
Is that the window Swan? Is that them?
Is that Swan? Is that him right there? No.
No.
Dude, I think that's Pat.
That's the way he pays tolls. He puts his arm out
that's
the window
not her
just
car.
Like that.
Oh wait, that is Pat, I think.
We're showing ourselves
no.
out.
No.
Looks like his arm.
All right. I wonder if he even sees us. Uh-oh.
Yeah,
oh, fuck!
He's pulling over.
Fuck. Eli.
Yeah.
We do know Pat.
No,
we don't know. We don't know Pat.
Dude, I think we should. I think we should just go, dude. Hey, and just say, yeah, he's not playing with us though.
Hi there. How are you? We live in California. Yep.
What should we do, boys? Let's get a
stick with the story. Please.
Stick with the story.
Norm. Stick with the story.
Norm.
Stick with it.
I don't know who I know and who I don't know.
Well, the plan today, which obviously went over extremely well, since Pat had a criminal record but the main thing being that his name was fucked up on his work permit, so he went through as an individual, and since I don't have a work permit with this group, I was going through as an individual. So we thought we'd play it off like we were the happy couple. In general, it was a fine plan, but something about the way Pat and I looked, I guess. Well, the official explanation that we got was that we didn't look like the perfect couple because it was the wrong time of year and I was too young.
I don't know if it's doing anything. No.
You okay, buddy?
Don't do that.
You got a rubber on you?
Oh, dude, fuck, a rubber on Miles? I don't even spit on it. I just put it in.
Santa Claus!
Backstage with no door.
Backstage with no brains.
Fucking uppers.
No, I think it's probably the jackets off. These all look fine.
Amphetamines to the road. Good thing they didn't check my bag at the border. There's a loony right there. Barely legal that someone was gonna leave in the bathroom in Burlington, Vermont. Can't leave shit like that laying around. Vanity Fair that Eli's wife left in our. Whoa. Now they're also a Sweets postcard. Those are free. Anything that's free, you take it. Tax refund for business travel to Canada since I'm making a shitload of money. Figured this will come in. Well, I'm on tour. It comes up to 22.5 cents per hour.
I'm
Hey guys with the fridge.
Shut the fuck up.
After this light, I'm parking.
Get two cases.
Two cases.
Two cases of Brad House.
All right, who wants to play this?
Who's going
to
play it?
All the time around the fire, all the warmth within the fire. Don't believe in magazines.
No, that's...
I bet you made me drink that shit.
Just like
good, so I'll try this.
Just leave it. When we die, you better know your campfire songs.
Volume. It's gotta go down.
Well, all you got when your death is memories of campfire songs.
No chorus, or verse.
No, good chorus.
10,000 years around and wrapped shrouds put around your mouth. Let it ring.
Have you seen the,
Canadian?
Have you seen the new American 20? Actually,
no,
it's
I don't.
Quite interesting.
I couldn't care
brand
less.
New.
Yeah, way to go.
The Americans are trying.
Yeah,
that's all I want to say to Canada is Americans are trying.
If they're not making war against someone, they're creating interesting colored bills.
Time to go home.
Well, you know what? You have to do something in your spare time.
Kill those motherfuckers.
You can't kill. You can't kill 24 hours a day.
What's your point? Yeah.
Well, the point is that
get to the point, and otherwise,
the point is that war is bullshit, and
I agree with that.
And declaring war on corporate society is
but you just said declaring war is bullshit, but then declaring war on corporate society is okay.
Do you have another way of thinking?
No, just consistency.
It's a little bizarre, isn't it? Because, like, American...
Stop.
Stopped.
All right, we're going home now.
Everyone's going home, but there's still $120 worth of beer coming to this place, which,
yeah.
I just pissed off the people that I invited to my home. I'm a huge fan of the band. I named When Your Heartstrings Break the best album of that year and put it on a listening post. Somehow I pissed off people that I didn't want to piss off.
Hey, I don't know. I'm really upset.
Pissed off. Like,
I don't think he even remembers you anymore. I don't think you're upset.
Yeah, I'm sure you're right.
That was fucked up. That was fucked up. After hours, there's a fucking guy. He's gonna bring us beer. After hours, whatever. So we're there. We're in his bachelor pad. We're like, whatever, you know. IKEA to the max, which is ironic because he's anti-corporate, anti-American, but he's got fucking Swedish fucking sweatshop furniture in his house. Next thing I know, somehow it's my fucking fault that we bombed Iraq. Everybody who's fucking got some sort of semblance of like patriotic fucking bullshit bails. Fucking Chuckles comes up to me and says, hey man, we gotta go with $160. That fucking Hell's Angels. You know the Toronto Sales Angels? They run everything. That guy, I mean, at the end of the day, Nathan, you're a fucking cocksucker. You're a good host to start with, but, like, you turn the tables, man.
Nice time on our honeymoon. Last night was beautiful.
Sweet. Here they are again. Hi, lucky.
I think I should tell you, I don't feel so hot tonight. I have some big problems. Most people would either call them sick or in bed for a day or two. It's not just where you could care of myself on the road. I'm a bit of an idiot. No offense to Minneapolis, it's just this cold thing. Once you hit it, it fucks your shit up. I'm a Californian, which means I'm a pussy.
Thursday, we're fucked. We'll probably be out of there by then. Because it looked like there was snow in Wyoming.
Okay, how do we get out of here? I didn't check the map. Hold on, sorry about this. Oh, we'll take this out. 394
west. 394 west, that's what we're doing.
I see maybe a little bit of disenchantment maybe in the whole indie scene.
I always had disenchantment with the indie scene. Like, I really don't want to hear from some kid telling me, like I just got the other day an email telling me that he thinks that we could have played better and we should do this and this and that when we do a live show. I don't tell him how to scoop his fries at McDonald's. You know? I mean, and I don't think he should tell me that we should play our songs quieter, that we're lacking some sort of groove. All I know is I'm on tour with my friends and we're playing music. That's all I care about.
Miles has got a sore throat, and he may not be able to sing tonight. So I am Plan B. I'd sing the lyrics for songs for years and not know what they mean.
I can cue you over. I'll get in the corner and put a black drape over myself. Cue you with the lyrics.
A lot of songs I double or octave anyway, so there's only like a few. Like Sunday Under Glass, I don't sing the verses. Man Like Me and Landslide Baby, I don't. Good Man Is Easy to Kill, I don't.
That song's gonna be tough.
Which one?
Good Man's Easy to Kill.
It'll be fun to try and sing and play the trumpet at the same time. That should be a blast. I've always tried to perfect that technique. It hasn't worked so far. Let's see what happens.
All right, here I am.
I'm going to interrogate you all about that story.
We're going to 13-year-old. Now we're going to Canada, right?
What is this about?
I don't know.
What is this all about?
We're a band, and we're going to a show, and we're a little late, and we have all our work permits, which we've already gone into Montreal and Toronto, and we've come back into the States. We've also had a call put in from the promoter at the venue who's spoken to somebody on the commercial part of this that we would be coming through, and there should be no problem. In terms of big holdups or whatever, since we've already come in and out, you know?
You're in a big rush, is what you're telling me.
Yeah, sorry.
Thank you.
my favorite band. Neil, the trumpet player, sang tonight. Wow, what was amazing. I don't know. I'm overwhelmed.
I think Swanee did a wonderful job last night. Absolutely wonderful. I like when he's trying to multitask though. Comes up and hits the mic with his face. That's awesome.
No DAC. Throwing down, boy.
How do I know you're not putting cocaine in your tires, old man?
Oh.
The paperwork for the registered equipment.
Yeah. Ask him if he wants me to get out and walk back.
Yes. Okay.
The cowboy set you up. I have to go with Bill on that. It's in the dog.
Name Mystic.
You guys are asking me.
No, no way.
Dude, that dude's totally got weed in his car. No wonder they're searching.
Usually the Americans are far more aggressive, actually. The Canadians keep you longer, but the Americans have been really kind of mean. We've decided this might be the last time we go to Canada after all this.
How about this as a variation on the Brandon hat? I'll one-up that little fucker. He may be better looking than me, but my hat is on right. I have to admit, he is a good-looking individual. Brandon, he's fucking. He's kind of got like, kind of crossing like Hugh Grant and Sylvester Stallone. First question is, who would you fuck, JV or our boy?
JV or Brandon?
Who would you fuck?
Brandon. Yeah. Who would you fuck?
I'd fuck JV, I think. He acts like a real. He'd probably snuggle like a motherfucker too when you were done. He'd probably just be nice and warm and just cuddle up right by you.
Post-coital JV.
Yeah, I bet he'd be very good. The act of coitus might not be quite so gratifying, but the post-coitus would be amazing.
It'd be quick. It would be like...
It would be quick,
like
too.
Like three and out.
Yeah, for you or him. Yeah, pretty much I'd fuck all of JV's band before I'd fuck a single Beulah. Okay. Maybe Abby. Abby might fit in there somewhere.
I don't think I'd fuck anybody in Beulah. I'd fuck the other band. Just because I don't know them so well, so... But I'd fuck JV's band just because I don't know him. 12 beers and a fucking blow to the head. I'm there.
Oh my god, dude. Don't move. Do not move.
What?
Jay? Jay is a woman.
Oh!
As a band camper.
Oh my god.
Straight up, Jay. There's
oh
your,
my god.
There's your life. There's
fucked
your,
up.
There's your life partner right there, pal.
And she gave it to show. You. She was cute, too.
We had two hotels. We had the bad one, then we moved to the good
sometimes
one.
Sometimes they're okay, quality ends, right?
Yes. We've had some good ones. Yeah, they've been quality.
The last one was the low quality.
In our room, yeah, there was a weird blood stain on the wall in the sports center. It was really weird. Like somebody had wiped off most of it, but they're
I only got one night left.
Oh.
Oh, one more night of cock blocking.
Oh.
Still got a night left, my friend.
I'm all torn up about it.
We'll finally get some pussy.
It's kind of a bummer. I never had a problem.
No, I actually like Jay.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, I think it's funny. I think
we were talking about that the other day. It was Eli that was saying that.
You did have it out for him for a while.
It was hard to work with him. He was irritating. He is annoying. Don't get me wrong.
How could we?
But I do like him, you know, at the end of the day. You know what I mean? Why do I cut Jay slack? I guess part of it's because he doesn't get paid. Part of it is because, you know, I mean, like, this should be fun. In the end, you know what I mean? Like, I really think, I really do believe that. And like, you know, I mean, if I'm really, he's really pissing me off, I'll fucking come after him for sure. But right now, I mean, like, you know, he's doing the noble thing. He's trying to get laid. I think it's important that, you know, there is some tail had, even if it is Jay that has it. And even if it is a man, disguised as a woman, that fools him.
I just want to say there's gonna be a tall, lanky, nerdy looking kid coming up here. His name is Jay Underwood. He'll be around here for a week walking your city. He wrote, kept writing us and writing us and writing us and writing us, saying that he wanted to road manage, but we wouldn't let him road manage. We said he could become our assistant, which meant anything we wanted. So for the last 30 days, up until this day, because this is the last day of tour, he's been doing anything we wanted, and we're not paying him.
Starts to smear on the scene. Pulls a grand entrance. Silver screen.
Oh, and they do pay me, but it's all in sweet loving.
True. Sometimes it's not so sweet.
Day moment to moment, you know, which I think is a smart way to be in a band, you know. Everybody's got to break up in a band, and whether or not we break up tomorrow, if we break up next month, or we break up in 6 months, it doesn't really matter. We might decide that we can't live without each other, and we have to make another record.
And the stars refuse to shine for you, they do it just to spy, they know. Trying to hide. So smile, please smile. I just want you happy.
These bands that you love so much, they're short-lived, and you should take the time to listen to them and go to their shows. Because there's nothing more infuriating than getting an email from some kid who says, oh man, I just missed you in Tucson because me and my girlfriend went to the movies. You gotta come back real soon. Well, real soon, just sometimes it's never. People need to realize that. Your girlfriend will be there tomorrow. Take her to the movies tomorrow. Go see Beulah tonight.